From his celestial travels, the Venerable Moggallana explained that he saw virtuous followers of the Buddha in various states of heavenly rebirths. In addition, he saw that the followers of other sects that lacked moral conduct ended up in hell rebirths. This caused many people to convert from other sects to Buddhism. The leaders of the sects were very upset at the loss of fame, income, comfort, and support from their old members. They argued about what they should do. Instead of looking within themselves, the leaders blamed the loss of support on the Venerable Moggallana. They came to the consensus that revenge was their best option. They decided to hire professional criminals to assassinate the Venerable Moggallana. The Venerable Moggallana, being the foremost in psychic powers of all beings other than the Buddha, realized their intentions. Being an Arahan, he no longer had fear of death, because he knew he would reach Nibbana, never to be born again. Rather, he had compassion for the lost and confused souls that wished him harm. Killing an Arahan is one of the five karukama, evil karmas that yield the most horrendous results. The five karukama are: killing your mother, killing your father, killing an Arahan, causing a Buddha to bleed, causing a break in the Sangha. The hired assassins watched from a distance and saw that the Venerable Moggallana was inside his kuti. However, when they kicked the door in, they found that no one was inside. They were confused since they knew he was in there when they approached. What they didn't know was that when the Venerable Moggallana sensed that the assassins were near, he used his abilities to disappear. For 6 days, the criminals returned and bursted into the kuti. Each time they did so, they found that the kuti was empty. And on the 7th day, when the Venerable Moggallana sensed their return, he used his psychic powers to discern how many more times they would come back. He determined that they would not stop until they had killed him. Upon further searching, he saw that this was a remnant of the karukama that he had committed a long time ago. Although he had already burned in the lowest hells for longer than the mind can understand, the evil of that karma had not yet been fully repaid. He then understood that no matter how many times he wished to save the criminals from creating a karukama, he could not escape his own karma. So, on their 7th try, the criminals burst in and found the Venerable Moggallana sitting in his usual spot. They grabbed him and dragged him outside, where they proceeded to beat him viciously. Seeing the monk was close to death, they left him to die in the forest. Then, they went to report the news and to collect their reward. Deep in their hearts, they knew that what they had done was morally disgusting and vile. Yet their greed and desire for money overshadowed their sense of morality. With his last ounces of strength, The Venerable Moggallana used his psychic abilities to repair some of his broken bones and organs. He flew to the Buddha to say his last farewells before he died. When he arrived in front of the Buddha, he said, "Master, today is my last day on this earth, and will be my last forever. I will soon enter Nibbana." Moggallana, there have been no better chief disciples than you and Sariputta. After today, I will not ever be able to look upon your face again. Before you leave, express the Dhamma so that all may hear." The Venerable Moggallana took his seat in the air and performed miracles and supernatural feats while preaching the Dhamma. The heavens shook and the devas and gods cried, knowing that they would not see another holy being such as him again for immeasurable amounts of time. The monks present were shaken by the depth and eloquence of his Dhamma, and many progressed further in their practice. And finally, when he was finished, the Venerable Moggallana paid his last respects to the Buddha and flew away to his last resting spot, where he entered final Nibbana. And after his body was cremated, all that remained of the Venerable Moggallana were his Arahant relics, the final physical proof that he was truly an Arahant. What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.